to serve even in the absence of your pastors.
En servir aún en la ausencia de sus pastores.
And ensuring the work of the Lord goes on.
Y mostrar que el trabajo del Señor continúa.
I'm with you this morning is my beloved wife, Pastor Esther.
Conmigo en esta mañana está mi esposa hermosa, la pastora Esther.
And we have Deacon Wayne Sloss with us this morning.
Y tenemos al líder acá con nosotros esta mañana.
Amen. I bring you greetings from Progress Church.
Les traigo saludos de la iglesia Progress, Progress Church.
It's a joy for us to be here today.
Es un gozo estar con ustedes acá.
Good to meet you, brother.
Pleasure to meet you.
Amen. I think the last time I spoke, Sister Claudia transferred it for me, so we have a new worker here by my side today.
Amen. La última vez que yo hablé, nuestra hermana Claudia me tradujo, pero hoy tenemos un otro siervo acá con nosotros.
Amen. Before I share, let me just call my wife to bring brief greetings to you this morning.
Antes de que comparta, quiero llamar a mi esposa para que les salude esta mañana.
Good morning.
Buenos días.
It's so good to be among God's people.
Es tan bueno estar alrededor de la
gente de Dios. We are one. We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the Lord.
Somos
Amen.
Uno en el Espíritu, somos uno en el
Praise
Señor.
God. Now, whenever you go into a house, the first thing you look for is the Spirit of the Lord. Amen.
Ahora, cuando tú entras en una casa por primera vez, lo primero que buscas es el Espíritu de Dios.
Sorry about that. Because we understand that where the Spirit of God is,
porque entendemos que donde está el Espíritu de Dios,
there is liberty.
Ahí hay libertad.
Amen. And as the praise team lift up the name of Jesus, you can sense the anointing and the liberty in the room.
Y mientras que el equipo de alabanza levantaba el nombre de Jesús, tú podías sentir la unción y la libertad en este lugar.
Amen. And as the Spirit of God began to move, the Spirit began to speak to your heart, doesn't he?
Y mientras el Espíritu se mueve, el Espíritu de Dios comienza a hablarte a ti, ¿es cierto?
And this is what the Spirit of God was saying to me.
Y eso es lo que el Espíritu de Dios me decía a mí.
When we live by our flesh,
cuando vivimos por nuestra carne,
we are self-ruled.
Nos somos gobernados a nosotros mismos.
But when we live by the Spirit,
pero cuando vivimos en el Espíritu,
there is liberty in Christ Jesus.
Hay libertad en Cristo Jesús.
So as believers,
así que como creyentes,
we must submit ourselves to the Spirit of God.
Tenemos que rendirnos al Espíritu de Dios.
And live a life in the Spirit.
En el Espíritu.
I said live a life in the Spirit.
Yo dije vivir una vida en el Espíritu.
Live a life in the Spirit.
Vivir una vida en el Espíritu.
When you live a life in the Spirit, there is no bondage.
Cuando vives una vida en el Espíritu no hay ningún tipo de atadura.
Because we know the bondage breaker.
Porque conocemos al que rompe ataduras.
Aleluya.
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 God is here.
Dios está acá.
His Spirit is here.
Su Espíritu está acá.
Let us continue to submit ourselves.
Continuemos rindiéndonos ante él.
To the Spirit of God.
Al Espíritu de Dios.
And submit one to another.
Rindiéndonos los unos a los otros.
That the principles and the rule of God,
que los principios y la ley de Dios,
may cause the kingdom of God,
que haga que el reino de
to
Dios
advance in the earth,
avance en la tierra,
where there is peace and unity,
donde hay paz y unidad,
the Spirit can work.
El Espíritu puede trabajar.
It's good to be here. God bless you.
Es muy bueno estar acá. Dios los bendiga.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise his name. I want to read a passage of scripture.
Quiero leerles un pasaje en la palabra.
In 1 Peter chapter 2.
En la primera, en primera de Pedro, capítulo 2.
From verses 4 to verses 9.
Del versículo 4 al versículo 9.
Why don't you just stand? I'll read and you follow. Just stand.
¿Por qué no te pones de pie? Yo leo y tú me sigues.
I'm going to read from the New King James Version.
Voy a leer de la versión en español sería la Reina Valera.
So I'll read it and you'll read.
That's okay. Right.
Coming to him as living stones, rejected indeed by men, but chosen by God and precious, you also as living stones are built up a spiritual house, a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. Therefore, it is also contained in the scriptures. Behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious, and he who believes on him will by no means be put to shame. Therefore, to you who believe, he is precious, but to those who are disobedient, the stone which the builder rejected has become the chief cornerstone, and a stone of stumbling and a rock of offense. They stumbled being disobedient to the word to which they also were appointed. But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, for his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Acercándoos a él, piedra viva, desechada ciertamente por los hombres, mas para Dios escogida y preciosa. Vosotros también, como piedras vivas, sed edificados como casa espiritual y sacerdocio santo, para ofrecer sacrificios espirituales aceptables a Dios por medio de Jesucristo. Por lo cual también contiene la escritura: he aquí, pongo en Sion la principal piedra de ángulo, escogida preciosa, y el que creyere en él no será avergonzado. Para vosotros, pues, los que creéis, él que es precioso. Pero para los que no creen, la piedra que los edificadores desecharon ha venido a ser la cabeza del ángulo, y piedra de tropiezo y roca que hace caer, porque tropiezan en la palabra, siendo desobedientes, a lo cual fueron también destinados. Mas vosotros sois linaje escogido, real sacerdocio, nación santa, pueblo adquirido por Dios, para que anunciéis las virtudes de aquel que os llamó de las tinieblas a su luz admirable.
Aleluya. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Padre, en el nombre de Jesús.
We thank you for your word.
Te damos gracias por tu palabra.
You call us today.
Tú nos has llamado hoy.
To be a living stone.
A ser una piedra viva.
Built up.
Una piedra construida.
For you.
Para ti.
I pray today, God.
Yo oro hoy, Padre.
That we will build a house.
Que podamos ser la casa.
For your presence.
Para tu presencia.
Touch our lives.
Toca nuestras vidas.
May we conform.
Que nos conformemos.
May we be knitted together.
Que podamos estar
as living stones today.
Como piedras vivas.
For your glory.
Para tu gloria.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Amen.
Amen.
Before you have your seat.
Y antes de que se sienten.
Will you just tell at least two persons today? Tell at least two persons.
Dile a dos personas.
I'm building a house.
Estoy construyendo una casa.
For his presence.
Para su presencia.
I'm building a house.
Estoy construyendo una casa.
For his presence.
Para su presencia.
Hallelujah. Praise his name. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Ya se pueden sentar en la presencia del Señor.
In this passage of scripture we read this morning,
en este pasaje o escritura que leímos esta mañana,
the Bible tells us we are living stones.
La palabra nos dice que somos piedras vivas.
We are living stones of the church that Jesus is building.
Somos piedras vivas de la iglesia que Dios está construyendo.
In Matthew 16 verses 18, Jesus said, "I will build my church."
En Mateo 16 capítulo versículo 18, Jesús dice, "Construiré mi iglesia."
We are part of the body of Christ.
Somos parte del cuerpo de Cristo.
As living stones, we have new life in us.
Como
hallelujah.
Piedras vivas, tenemos vida nueva en nosotros.
For 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, if any man be in Christ,
porque la segunda de Corintios capítulo 5:17 dice, si algún hombre está en Cristo,
he is a new creature.
Es una nueva criatura.
All things,
todas las cosas,
passed away.
Ya han pasado.
All things,
todas las cosas,
become new.
Se vuelven nuevas.
Jesus is our master builder.
Jesús es nuestro constructor maestro.
And as living stone, God places us where he wants us to be.
Y como piedras vivas, Dios nos posiciona en los lugares donde él quiere que estemos.
He sets in the body.
Él se hace en el cuerpo.
Wherever he desires us to be.
Él coloca el cuerpo donde él desea estar.
Do you know, as living stones,
ustedes saben que como piedras vivas,
we are connected to each other.
Estamos conectados los unos a los otros.
Tell your neighbor, say neighbor.
Dile a tu vecino, vecino.
I'm connected to you.
Estoy conectado a ti.
Tell them, I'm a part of you.
Tell them, yo soy parte de ti.
We are connected.
Estamos conectados.
One towards another.
El uno al otro.
Hallelujah. In this passage we see this morning,
En este pasaje que vimos esta mañana,
it means that our lives are solidly centered on Christ.
Significa que nuestras vidas están centradas en una manera sólida en Cristo.
When we are built on Jesus,
cuando estamos construidos en Jesús,
it means that Jesus is steady.
Eso significa que Jesús es estable.
He is immovable.
Él es inmovible.
He is a sure foundation.
Él es una fundación segura.
A foundation that can stand the difficulties and the challenges of life.
Una fundación que puede soportar las dificultades y los retos de la vida.
One hymn say, "On Christ the solid rock I stand."
En Juan dijo, "En Jesús la piedra fuerte yo estoy."
All other ground.
Todo otro piso
is sinking sand.
Es como arena que se hunde.
So it's good to be built on the foundation of Jesus Christ.
Así que es bueno estar construido en la fundación de Cristo Jesús.
Hallelujah. We are connected to Jesus himself.
Estamos conectados a Jesús.
He is the chief cornerstone.
Él es la piedra de angular de arriba.
And because he is the chief cornerstone,
y como él es esa piedra de arriba angular,
we are to ensure we are connected in the right way.
Tenemos que asegurarnos que estamos conectados en la manera correcta.
When you bring a stone from the quarry, I was thinking about that word, quarry.
Quarry.
Where you get stones from.
Yeah, puede ser depósito.
All right. So when you bring a stone from the quarry,
cuando traes una piedra de un depósito de piedras,
you have to chisel that stone.
Tienes que sacarle punta a esa
you
piedra.
Have to shape that stone.
Tienes que sacarle forma a esa piedra.
In order the stone can be fitted.
Para que la piedra pueda caber.
In the right places.
En los lugares indicados.
There are some of us here this morning.
Hay algunos de nosotros acá esta mañana.
That Jesus, the master builder.
Que Jesús, el constructor maestro.
Is still working on. Hallelujah.
Que todavía está trabajando con nosotros.
There are some rough edges.
Que algunos filos que están todavía un poco duros.
In our lives.
En nuestras vidas.
That need to be smooth out.
Que tienen que ser vueltos suaves.
It could be our speech.
Puede ser la manera como hablamos.
Let him smooth out your speech this morning.
Deja que él suavice como tú hablas.
It could be your attitude.
Puede ser tu actitud.
Let him smooth it out for you this morning.
Deja que él afile tu actitud.
It could be your self-centeredness.
Puede ser tu la manera como tú te centras a ti mismo.
Let him smooth it out today.
Deja que él la ponga suave.
It could be stubbornness.
Puede ser tu terquedad.
It could be pride.
Puede ser tu orgullo.
But because he is the master builder,
pero como él es el constructor maestro,
he knows what needs to be removed from our lives.
Él sabe qué debe ser quitado de nuestras
so
vidas.
I'm willing to submit to him.
Así que yo estoy dispuesto a rendirme a él.
He is the potter.
Él es el constructor.
I am the clay.
Yo soy, él es el moldeador. Yo
he,
soy
is
la
the,
cera.
He is the master builder.
Él es el constructor maestro.
I'm just a living stone.
Yo simplemente soy una piedra viva.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, "Build me, Lord Jesus."
Alguien diga, Jesús, constrúyeme.
Make me into a living stone.
Hazme una piedra viva.
That's built up on you today.
Que pueda ser construida en ti hoy.
Hallelujah. You got to understand.
Tienes que entender.
As living stones,
y como piedras vivas,
we cannot stand on our own.
No nos podemos parar nosotros mismos.
We must be joined.
Tenemos que estar juntos.
Into the greater structure.
Para crear una estructura mayor.
In the kingdom.
En el reino,
there is no lone ranger.
No hay llanero solitario.
In the kingdom,
en el reino,
you cannot stand alone.
Tú no puedes mantenerte solo.
In the kingdom,
en el reino,
you got to be connected.
Tienes que estar conectado.
One towards another.
El uno con el otro.
Because iron sharpen iron.
Porque el hierro afila el hierro.
I'm here to build you up.
Yo estoy acá para construirte.
He's here to build me up.
Él está acá para construirme.
He's here to encourage me.
Él está acá para darme fuerzas.
I'm here to lift up his hands.
Yo estoy acá para levantar sus manos.
When it hangs down.
Abajo,
I'm here to encourage him.
Le estoy acá para darle fuerzas,
because we are walking together.
Porque estamos caminando juntos,
we are growing together.
Estamos creciendo juntos,
we are serving together.
Estamos sirviendo juntos,
we are worshiping together.
Estamos adorando
come
juntos.
On, someone lift your hands and praise
levante
the Lord.
Tus manos y adora a Jesús en esta mañana.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As living stones,
como piedras vivas,
when we are connected to each other,
cuando estamos conectados los
we
unos
must
a los
recognize
otros, tenemos que reconocer,
that's how we can have success.
Así es como podemos tener éxito.
each one of us.
Cada uno de nosotros.
Maybe individual in our gifts.
Podemos tener dones individuales.
But in order to advance the kingdom,
para avanzar el reino,
we are connected.
Estamos conectados.
Each one of you this morning.
Cada uno de ustedes esta mañana.
You may be individual in the gift.
Ustedes pueden tener un don individual.
But in order to advance Maranatha Toronto,
pero para avanzar Maranatha Toronto,
you must be connected.
Tienen que estar conectados.
You must serve together.
Tienen que servir juntos.
You must work together.
Tienen que trabajar juntos.
To advance the kingdom of God.
Para avanzar el reino de Dios.
Or touch your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Oh,
you cannot be a lone ranger.
No puede ser un llanero solitario.
Let us serve together.
Sirvamos juntos.
Hallelujah. When we look at this passage of scripture,
cuando vemos esta escritura,
I'm so glad.
Estoy tan feliz.
That Jesus chose me.
Estoy tan dichoso que Jesús me escogió a mí.
He chose you.
Te escogió a ti.
Hallelujah. When we were no people,
cuando éramos nadie,
he came and he chose us.
Él vino y nos escogió.
For he said, you are chosen generation.
Porque él dijo, ustedes son linaje escogido.
A royal priesthood.
Un sacerdocio real.
A peculiar people.
Una gente peculiar.
You have been chosen by God.
Han sido escogidos por Dios.
Somebody lift your hand and say, thank
levanta
you, Jesus.
Levanta tus manos y dile, gracias, Jesús.
You have been chosen by God.
Han sido escogidos por Dios.
You got to recognize it's an honor.
Tienen que reconocer que es un honor.
For the king of the universe.
Para que el rey del universo.
To choose you.
Te haya escogido a ti.
We didn't choose him.
Nosotros no lo escogimos.
He chose us.
Él nos escogió a nosotros.
He chose us.
Él nos escogió a
and
nosotros.
He said he chose us.
Y nos escogió a nosotros.
That we should show forth his praise.
Tenemos que mostrar su gloria.
Because he have called us.
Porque nos ha llamado.
Out of darkness.
Nos ha sacado de la oscuridad.
Into his marvelous light.
A su luz maravillosa.
All through the scriptures.
Alrededor de las escrituras.
We see men have been building.
Vemos que los hombres han estado construyendo.
A house,
una casa,
a tabernacle,
un tabernáculo,
in order to house the presence of God,
para poder darle una casa a la presencia de Dios.
Today we are under a new covenant.
Hoy estamos bajo un pacto nuevo.
If we go back in scriptures,
si nos devolvemos en las escrituras,
in Exodus chapter 25,
en Éxodo capítulo 25,
it tells us that Moses built a tabernacle.
Ahí nos dice que Moisés construyó un tabernáculo
to house the presence of God,
para darle casa a la presencia de Dios.
This tabernacle of Moses,
ese tabernáculo de Moisés,
it was something great.
Era algo grandioso.
It was magnificent.
Era maravilloso.
It had splendor.
Tenía esplendor.
And it cost.
Y costó.
It costs to build for his presence.
Cuesta construir algo para su presencia.
If you and I are going to build our bodies,
si nosotros vamos a construir nuestros cuerpos,
our lives,
nuestras vidas,
for him to dwell in,
para que él viva en ellas,
it will cost you something.
Va a tener un costo. Un precio.
Are you with me?
¿Están conmigo?
We want God to live in us.
Queremos que Dios viva en nosotros.
His spirit dwells in us.
Que su espíritu viva en
nosotros.
But
we are not willing to make the sacrifice.
Pero no estamos dispuestos a hacer los sacrificios.
We do not want it to cost us anything.
No queremos que nos cueste nada.
But if we are going to build a temple,
pero si vamos a construir un
templo,
if we're
going to build lives for his presence to dwell in,
si vamos a construir vidas para que su presencia viva en ellas,
it will cost you something.
Te va a costar algo.
It means it will cost you time.
Te va a costar tiempo.
Time in his presence.
Tiempo en su presencia.
Time with him.
Tiempo con él.
It will cost you resources.
Te va a costar recursos.
It may even cost you some relationships that is not good for you.
Hasta te pueden costar relaciones que no son buenas
para ti. But you must be willing.
Pero tienes que estar dispuesto.
Hallelujah, to build.
Para construir.
You must be willing.
Tienes que estar dispuesto.
To build according to his standard.
Para construir acorde a sus estándares.
Moses build a tabernacle.
Moisés construyó el tabernáculo.
According to the standard which God gave.
Con los estándares que Dios le dio.
Today we have so many people.
Hoy tenemos tantas personas.
Who want to build their lives according to their own standard.
Que quieren construir sus vidas acorde a sus estándares.
But I want you to know this morning.
Pero les quiero contar esta mañana
that God is a God of order.
Que Dios es un Dios de orden.
There is a prescribed order by which we must build.
Hay un orden que fue dado a nosotros por el cual debemos construir.
That prescribed order is one of holiness.
Ese orden es uno de santidad.
One of consecration.
Es uno de consagración.
One of reading the word.
Es uno de leer la palabra.
One of prayer.
Es uno de oración.
One of fasting.
Es uno de ayuno.
But we must build according to the pattern of Almighty God.
Pero tenemos que construir acorde al patrón de nuestro Dios maravilloso.
Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor,
dile a tu vecino y dile vecino.
Build according to his pattern.
Construye acorde a su patrón.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Alguien diga aleluya.
So we saw Moses built.
Así que vimos a Moisés construir.
The heart must be willing.
El corazón debe estar dispuesto.
Are you hearing me? The heart must be willing.
Me están escuchando. El corazón debe estar dispuesto a construir.
We gotta check our hearts.
Tenemos que chequear nuestros corazones.
Because many times,
porque muchas veces,
God will speak to our hearts.
Dios va a hablar a nuestros corazones.
And we'll harden our hearts.
Y no tendremos corazones.
There are areas He wants us to remove. There are areas in our lives He wants us to remove.
Hay áreas en nuestras vidas que él quiere que nos quitemos.
But we have to heal ourselves.
Pero tenemos que sanarnos.
And we are saying to God today,
y hoy le estamos diciendo a Dios,
I will build,
yo construiré,
according to your pattern,
acorde a tu patrón.
So build according to his pattern.
Así que construye acorde al patrón de él.
We see in the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 15,
vemos en el libro de Primera de Crónicas capítulo 15,
that David prepared a tent,
que David construyó una carpa,
to house the temple of God, or the ark of the covenant of God,
para darle algún tipo de casa al el pacto de Dios.
After he brought it up from the house of Obed-Edom,
después de que lo trajo de la casa de Obed-Edom,
the Bible says that David prepared a tent.
La Biblia dice que David construyó una carpa.
I want to say to us this morning,
les quiero decir que es en esta mañana,
we need to prepare.
Tenemos que preparar
in order to build our lives for God.
Para poder construir nuestras vidas a Dios.
It means that we must be structured.
Eso significa que tenemos que tener estructura.
We must be determined.
Tenemos que estar determinados.
It means that you and I, as we build, there are areas in our lives that we need to reject.
Eso significa que mientras que estamos construyendo, hay áreas en nuestras vidas que tenemos que rechazar.
If you are not prepared,
si tú no estás preparado,
you will not be disciplined.
No vas a ser disciplinado.
In building right,
en construir de la manera correcta.
We get the word disciples.
Vemos a los discípulos.
From discipline.
Y vemos su disciplina.
We are disciplined followers of Jesus Christ.
Somos seguidores disciplinados de Jesucristo.
We must prepare ourselves.
Tenemos que prepararnos a nosotros mismos.
In building a house for His presence.
En construir una casa para su presencia.
So I want to say to all of us this morning.
Así que les quiero decir en esta mañana.
As we build a house for His presence.
Mientras cuando construimos una casa para su
presencia.
Hallelujah.
Let us prepare ourselves.
Preparémonos.
Let us prepare our hearts.
Preparemos nuestros corazones.
That give God's first place.
Que le den a Dios el primer lugar.
In our hearts.
En nuestros corazones.
Not second place.
No segundo lugar.
But first place.
Pero primer lugar.
For this is what the word of the Lord says.
Porque eso es lo que dice la palabra de Dios.
In Matthew 22.
En Mateo 22.
He tells us we are to love the Lord.
Nos dice que tenemos que amar al Señor.
With all of our hearts.
Con todo nuestro corazón.
With all of our soul.
Con toda nuestra alma.
With all of our mind.
Con toda nuestra mente.
Say to all of us this morning.
Les quiero decir a ustedes en esta
he
mañana.
He has first place.
Él tiene el primer lugar
in our lives.
En nuestras vidas.
Don't relegate him.
No le quites ese lugar.
To second place.
Y no lo pongas en segundo lugar.
But Jesus.
Pero Jesús.
Our eyes.
Nuestros ojos.
Are fixed on you.
Están puestos en ti.
He's the center of all eyes.
Él es el centro de nuestras vidas.
He's the center of all eyes.
Él es el centro de nuestras vidas.
When we give him first place,
cuando le damos a él el primer lugar,
it means we give him honor.
Significa que le estamos dando honor.
It means that he is the preeminence.
Significa que él es lo emanente.
He is at the top.
Él está arriba.
He comes first.
Él viene primero.
Nothing else.
Nada más.
So we honor him this morning.
Así que lo honramos en esta mañana.
Then we see Solomon building a temple.
Ahora vemos a Salomón construir un templo.
In 2 Chronicles chapter 3.
En Segunda de Crónicas capítulo 3.
The Bible tells us.
La Biblia nos dice.
That Solomon built a temple.
Que Salomón construyó un templo.
At an appointed time.
En un tiempo que fue dado específicamente.
I come here this morning.
Yo vengo acá esta
to
mañana
encourage us.
Para motivarlos.
Now is the time.
Ahora es el tiempo.
To rise up.
De levantarse.
And build a temple.
Y construir un templo.
For the Holy Spirit
para
to live in.
Para que el Espíritu Santo viva en él.
Don't wait for next year.
No, espera, no esperes al próximo
Don't wait
año.
For next month.
No esperes el próximo mes.
Now is the time.
Ahora es el tiempo.
God has something for you to do.
Dios tiene algo que tú tienes que
He
hacer.
Wants to send his glory.
Él quiere enviar su gloria.
To live inside of you.
Para que pueda vivir dentro
to
de ti.
To direct your lives.
Para que pueda dirigir
But
tu
you
vida.
Have been putting it off for too long.
Pero tú lo has estado moviendo hacia atrás por mucho tiempo.
You have been saying not now.
Tú has estado diciendo ahora no.
Maybe tomorrow.
De pronto mañana.
Maybe next week.
De pronto la
When I get older,
cuando esté más viejo,
when I'm married,
cuando esté casado,
but I want you to hear me today.
Pero quiero que tú me escuches
the
hoy.
Holy Spirit says,
el Espíritu Santo te dice,
now,
ahora,
now,
ahora.
Just touch your neighbor and say now.
Toca a alguien
Come
y diles,
on, touch
ahora.
Somebody and say now.
Toca a alguien y diles, ahora.
Don't wait for tomorrow.
No esperes mañana.
Now is your appointed time.
Ahora es tu tiempo
Come
asignado.
On, start building.
Comienza a construir.
Build for his glory.
Construye para su gloria.
When you build at the appointed time.
Cuando tú construyes en el tiempo asignado.
The glory of God.
La gloria de Dios.
Will come.
Vendrá.
Hallelujah and rest upon you.
Y descansará en ti.
Don't wait.
No esperes.
Because you might miss it.
Porque tú de pronto no la vas
But
a ver.
But when you build according to the timing of God.
Pero cuando construyes acorde al tiempo
Hallelujah.
De Dios.
He shows up.
Él llega
in a glorious way.
En una manera gloriosa.
For the word of the Lord says,
porque la palabra de Dios dice,
in Acts chapter 3,
en Hechos capítulo 3,
verse 19,
versículo 19,
he says to repent.
Él dice que te arrepientas
and be converted,
y puedas ser convertido.
For when the time of refreshing
porque cuando el tiempo de refrescamiento
shall come from the presence of God.
Venga de la presencia de Dios.
The Lord is sending a great anointing in this season.
El Señor está trayendo una unción mayor en esta temporada.
Don't miss it.
No la pierdas.
Build.
Construye.
Now.
Ahora.
Don't wait for tomorrow.
No esperes para mañana.
But build now.
Pero construye ahora.
Build now.
Construye ahora.
The fourth temple we see is Zerubbabel temple.
El cuarto templo que vemos es el templo de Zerubbabel.
Zerubbabel temple was built in Zechariah chapter 1 verse 16.
El templo de Zerubbabel fue construido en Zacarías capítulo 1 versículo 16.
And Zechariah chapter 4 verses 5 to 10.
Y Zacarías capítulo 4 versículos 5 al 10.
It's a temple of grace.
Era un templo de gracia.
And mercy.
Y misericordia.
In other words, God is giving you a second chance.
En otras palabras, Dios te está dando una segunda oportunidad.
You remember the first temple, Solomon temple?
¿Te acuerdas del templo de Salomón?
Solomon temple was destroyed.
El templo de Salomón fue destruido.
And Zerubbabel was sent with a direction to rebuild the temple.
Y Zerubbabel recibió una dirección para construir el templo que Dios quería.
And he rebuilt the temple.
Y él reconstruyó
But it was not like Solomon temple.
Pero no era como el templo de Salomón.
But Zerubbabel temple.
Pero el templo de Zerubbabel
was one of a second chance.
Era el templo de la segunda oportunidad. Era el templo de gracia.
One of mercy.
Era el templo de misericordia.
You may hear this morning.
Tú puedes escuchar esta mañana.
That may mean that some stuff.
Puedes estar acá en esta mañana y eso significa que hay ciertas cosas.
It has passed you by.
Que te han pasado.
But God is able to redeem.
Pero Dios es capaz de redimir.
God is able to give you a second chance.
Dios es capaz de darte una segunda oportunidad.
At the dedication of Zerubbabel temple.
En la dedicación del templo de Zerubbabel.
The older generation.
La generación antigua.
Who had seen Solomon temple.
Que había visto el templo de Salomón.
They were weeping.
Estaban llorando.
Because they remembered the splendor.
Porque se acordaban del esplendor.
And the glory.
Y de la gloria.
Of Solomon temple.
Del templo de Salomón.
But the younger generation who had not seen it.
Pero la generación nueva que no lo había visto.
They were rejoicing.
Estaban gozosos.
At this temple.
Con este templo.
I want you to know this morning.
Quiero que tú sepas en esta
mañana.
That
the God whom we serve.
Que el Dios que nosotros servimos.
He's a God of grace.
Él es un Dios de gracia.
And he's a God of mercy.
Él es un Dios de misericordia.
Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord.
Oh, bendecido sea el nombre del
Señor.
So
he says to you this morning.
Así que él te dice en esta mañana.
It is not by might.
No es por poder.
It is not by human power.
No es por poder.
But it's a house of mercy.
Pero es la casa de misericordia.
It's a house of grace.
Es la casa de gracia.
So this temple that God is building.
Así que este templo que Dios está construyendo.
It's not by your own hands.
No es por tus manos propias.
It's not by your own might.
No es por tu poder propio.
But it's by His Spirit.
Pero es por su espíritu.
It is by His Spirit.
Es por su espíritu.
So He's building a new temple this morning.
Así que está construyendo un templo. templo nuevo esta mañana.
Not one of hands.
No uno de manos.
Moses' temple was of hands.
El templo de Moisés era de manos.
David's tent was of hands.
La carpa de David era de manos.
Solomon's temple was of hands.
El templo de Salomón fue hecho con manos.
Zerubbabel's temple was of hands.
El templo de Zerubbabel fue construido con manos.
But God is building a new temple today.
Pero Dios está construyendo un templo nuevo hoy.
Come and lift your hands.
Levanta tus manos.
And say, Lord.
Y dije, Señor.
Build in me.
Construye en mí.
A temple.
Un templo.
That you can dwell in.
En el cual tú vivas.
The next temple is a spiritual house.
El siguiente templo es una casa espiritual.
Acts chapter 2.
Hechos capítulo 2.
Verses 1 to 4.
Versículo 1 al 4.
In Acts chapter 1, Jesus told the disciples to wait in Jerusalem.
En Hechos capítulo 1, Jesús le dijo a los discípulos que esperaran en Jerusalén.
You see, up to this point,
porque hasta este momento,
the Spirit of the Living God,
el Espíritu del Dios vivo,
it was confined.
Estaba siendo oprimido, como encarcelado,
to a specific place.
No, estaba siendo asignado y comprimido a un lugar específico.
But when the day of Pentecost came,
pero cuando llegó el día de Pentecostés,
hallelujah, things changed.
Las cosas cambiaron.
When the day of Pentecost came,
cuando llegó el día de Pentecostés,
they were all together.
Estaban todos juntos.
In one accord.
En un acorde.
In the upper room.
En el lugar alto.
And the Bible says,
y la Biblia dice,
that the Spirit of the Lord came into that room,
que el Espíritu del Señor entró a ese cuarto,
like a mighty rushing wind,
como un viento recio,
and it sat,
y se sentó,
it sat,
se sentó,
it sat,
se sentó,
upon each one,
en cada uno de ellos.
Oh, are you hearing me today?
Me están escuchando hoy.
It rested,
descansó,
upon each one.
En cada uno de ellos.
That means upon you.
Eso significa que es encima de ti.
It fell upon each one.
Cayó sobre cada
the
uno 120 de ellos.
That was in the upper room.
Los 120 que estaban
each
en ese
one of them
alto,
that day.
Cada uno de ellos en ese
became
día, se volvieron
a spiritual house.
Una casa espiritual.
No longer
ya no
was he restricted
ya no estaba restringido
to one place.
A solo un lugar.
But as today,
pero como hoy,
wherever I go,
donde yo vaya,
he's with me.
Él está conmigo.
Oh, blessed be the name of the
oh,
Lord.
Bendecido sea el nombre del Señor.
I'm at my home.
Estoy en mi casa.
He's with me.
Él está conmigo.
I'm on the job.
Estoy trabajando.
He's with me.
Él está conmigo.
I'm sleeping.
Estoy durmiendo.
He's with me.
Él está conmigo.
I'm awake.
Estoy despierto.
He's with me.
Él está conmigo.
As of this day,
desde este día,
Holy Spirit,
el Espíritu Santo,
dwells in me.
Vive en mí.
Hallelujah.
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 And because Holy Spirit dwells in me,
y porque el Espíritu Santo vive en mí,
I have a responsibility.
Tengo una responsabilidad.
Are you hearing me? I have a responsibility.
Tengo una responsabilidad
to build this house,
en construir esta casa,
where he can live in,
donde él pueda vivir.
On the Moses tabernacle,
en el tabernáculo de Moisés,
only the Levites had responsibilities.
Los levitas tenían responsabilidades.
On the David's tent,
en la carpa de David,
he bring the Levites and other singers, and they had that responsibility.
Él trajo todos los cantantes y todos los levitas y tenían una responsabilidad.
On the Solomon's temple, only the Levites and the priests, they had that responsibility.
En los templos, en el templo de Salomón, los levitas y los sacerdotes tenían su responsabilidad.
Under the old covenant,
bajo el pacto antiguo,
only a select few,
solamente unos seleccionados,
had the responsibility,
tenían la responsabilidad,
to God, Holy Spirit,
para guiar.
To guard the presence of God.
Para guardar, para proteger la presencia
de Dios. But today, brothers and sisters.
Pero hoy, hermanos y hermanas.
Today, brothers and sisters.
Hoy, hermanos y hermanas.
You and I.
Tú y yo.
You and I.
Tú y yo.
We have access.
Tenemos acceso.
To the throne of Almighty God.
Al trono de nuestro Dios poderoso.
You and I.
Tú y yo.
We are temples.
Somos templos.
Of the living God.
Del Dios viviente.
You and I.
Tú y yo.
He lives. lives in us.
Él vive en nosotros.
You and I.
Tú y yo.
We are his sons and daughters.
Somos sus hijos y hijas.
You and I.
Tú y yo.
He is our father.
Él es nuestro padre.
You and I.
Tú y yo.
We are chosen.
Somos los escogidos.
You and I.
Tú y yo.
We are royal priesthood.
Somos sacerdocio
real. You and I.
Tú y yo.
We have access.
Tenemos acceso
to the throne of grace.
Al trono de gracia.
We can come boldly. We can come boldly.
Podemos ir a bolos.
And we can offer up
y podemos ofrecer
the sacrifices,
los sacrificios
of praise
y adoración
unto Almighty God.
Al Dios poderoso.
Come on, take 30 seconds.
Toma 30 segundos.
Lift your hands.
Levanta tus manos.
Give him the fruit of your lips.
Y dale el fruto de tus
bless
labios.
His name.
Bendice su nombre.
Somebody open your mouth.
Alguien le abre tu
and
boca.
Praise the Lord.
Y adora al Señor.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh, thank God.
Gracias, Jesús.
Thank God.
Gracias, Dios.
Thank God.
Dale gracias a Dios.
My friends.
Mis amigos.
Under the old covenant.
Bajo el pacto antiguo.
Once a year.
Una vez al año.
The high priest.
El sacerdote, el alto, el sacerdote grande.
He went in and offered up sacrifice or made atonement for himself and the sins of the people.
Él entraba y hacía un sacrificio para sí mismo y para los pecados del pueblo.
And every so often on special days, the people would bring an animal to offer up sacrifices for their sins.
Y en ciertos días especiales la gente traía animales para sacrificarlos por sus pecados.
But under this new covenant,
pero bajo este pacto nuevo,
we have a high priest.
Tenemos un sacerdote grande.
Who have entered.
Que ha entrado
into the Holy of Holies.
Al Santo de los Santos.
And he gave himself.
Y se dio a sí mismo.
One time.
Una vez.
One time.
Una vez.
For my sins.
Por mis pecados.
For your sins.
Por tus pecados.
For your sins.
Por tus pecados.
And he declared.
Y él declaró.
It is finished.
Está hecho.
And when he made that declaration.
Y cuando hizo esa declaración.
The Bible tells us.
La Biblia nos dice.
That the curtain.
Que la cortina
in the holy of, in the high priest in the temple.
En el templo.
It rent it from top to bottom.
Se rasgó de arriba hacia abajo.
Removing the veil.
Quitando el manto.
Removing the walls.
Quitando las paredes.
And today you and I.
Y hoy tú y yo.
We can come boldly to him.
Podemos venir a santos
where we can find grace.
Donde podemos encontrar
gracia. And there are times we need mercies.
En los tiempos donde necesitamos
misericordia. There are times when we sin.
En esos tiempos donde pecamos.
We don't have to wait until somebody go in and offer up sacrifices for us. But
so
tell your neighbor, say neighbor,
dile a tu vecino, dile
I'm
vecino,
building a temple.
Estoy construyendo un
and
templo.
Because I'm building a temple,
porque estoy construyendo un templo.
If I sin,
si yo peco,
he tell me if I confess my sins.
Si yo, él me dice que si confieso mis pecados.
He is
él es
faithful,
fiel,
and just. To forgive me
para perdonarme
of all of my sins,
de todos mis pecados.
I can approach him
yo puedo acercarme a él
and say, Lord,
y decirle, Señor,
forgive me.
Perdóname.
Lord,
Señor,
cleanse me.
Límpiame.
And there are times
y hay veces
when I feel cast down.
Donde me siento náufrago o separado.
There are times when I get knocked down.
Hay veces donde me siento en el piso.
But I'm so glad
pero estoy tan dichoso
that the Bible tells
que la Biblia me dice
that he's there to empower me.
Que él está ahí para empoderarme.
Somebody say empower.
Alguien diga empoderar.
He's there to lift me up.
Él está ahí para levantarme.
He's there to encourage me.
Él está ahí para darme fuerza.
I come by to tell somebody this morning.
Yo vengo acá para decirle a alguien esta mañana.
As you're building the temple.
Que mientras que tú construyes el templo.
Be strong in the Lord.
Sé fuerte en el Señor.
And in the power of his might.
Y en el poder de su grandeza.
Put on the whole armor of God.
Ponte la armadura del Señor.
Put on the whole armor of
ponte
God.
La armadura del Señor.
That you may be able to stand.
Que tú te puedas parar.
Against every wiles of the devil.
Ante cualquier tipo de artimaña del diablo.
And declare in yourself.
Y declarar en ti mismo.
No weapon.
Ningún arma.
Formed against me.
Formada contra mí.
Shall prosper.
Prosperará.
Because I'm building a temple.
Porque estoy construyendo un templo.
He has given me the tools.
Él me ha dado las herramientas.
And because he has given me the tools.
Y porque él me ha dado las herramientas.
The weapons of my warfare.
Las armas de mi milicia.
Are not carnal.
No son carnales.
But they are mighty.
Pero son poderosas.
Through God.
en Cristo.
For pulling down.
Porque él está jalando.
Stronghold.
Él está tumbando fortalezas.
It's not fleshly weapon.
No son armas carnales.
It's not human weapon.
No son armas humanas.
But the weapon I use.
Pero las armas que yo uso.
It is prayer.
Es oración.
All type of prayer.
Todo tipo de oración.
All kind of prayer.
Todo tipo de oración.
And supplication.
Y súplica.
In the spirit.
En el espíritu.
Are you hearing me?
Me están escuchando.
The weapon that I use.
La arma que yo uso.
Is the sword of the spirit.
Es la espada del espíritu.
Which is the word of God.
Que es la palabra de Dios.
The weapon that I use.
La arma que yo
uso. Is the word of Almighty God.
Es la palabra del Dios poderoso.
That is able to quench every fiery darts of the wicked ones.
Que puede destruir todo dardo de fuego del maligno.
The weapons I use.
Las armas que yo uso.
Are able to quench every plans of the enemy.
Pueden romper y destruir todo plan del enemigo.
Well, put your hands on your chest.
Pon tu mano en tu pecho.
And declare, I am building.
Y declara, yo estoy construyendo.
A temple.
Un templo.
For His presence.
Por su para su presencia.
Come on, declare, I am building.
Declara, yo estoy construyendo.
A temple.
Un templo.
For His presence.
Para su presencia.
Sit for a moment.
Pueden sentarse por un momento.
We are building.
Estamos construyendo.
As you build,
y mientras que tú construyes,
I want to encourage you this morning.
Te quiero motivar en esta mañana.
Build in covenant relationship.
Construye en una relación de pacto.
Are you hearing me?
¿Me están escuchando?
Don't break covenants.
No rompas pactos.
With your master builder.
No rompas el pacto con el constructor, constructor mayor.
Submit to him.
Ríndete a él.
He's a covenant keeper.
Él es el que guarda los pactos.
His word,
su palabra,
will accomplish,
va a cumplir,
whatever he sends it out to do.
Lo que él la envía a hacer.
If he says it,
y si él lo dice,
it shall come to pass.
Sucederá.
What you're building today,
lo que tú estás construyendo hoy,
build it
with
intercession.
Con intercesión.
It means that you got to learn how to stand in the gap.
Eso significa que tú tienes que aprender a pararte en el hueco.
You got to learn how to press your way through.
Tienes que aprender a presionar mientras que tú sigues en oración.
What you are building today,
lo que tú estás construyendo hoy,
is a place of brokenness before God.
Es un lugar quebrado ante Dios.
You have to be willing.
Tienes que estar dispuesto.
To fall on your face.
A caerte en tu cara.
Before Him.
Ante él.
There's something about the presence of God.
Hay algo en la presencia de Dios.
We must never take it lightly.
Que nunca podemos tomarla ligeramente.
If the prime minister would enter in here now,
si el primer ministro entrara por esa puerta acá,
there's a certain honor and protocol.
Hay un protocolo y una honra
that would immediately be put in place.
Que sucedería inmediatamente.
If the queen or some head of state would come in here,
si la reina o algún tipo de persona en alto estado entrara,
we would stand.
Nos levantaríamos.
Because we recognize.
Porque reconocemos.
Someone has come into the room.
Alguien ha entrado a este lugar.
That honor is due.
Que requiere honor.
When we come in the presence of God,
cuando venimos a la presencia de
don't
Dios,
take it lightly.
No la tomes ligeramente.
Are you hearing me?
¿Me estás escuchando?
When we enter a place of gathering like this,
cuando entramos un lugar de reunión como este,
don't take it lightly.
No lo tomes ligeramente.
Never become so familiar.
Nunca te vuelvas tan familiar
with His presence.
Con su presencia.
But we take it lightly.
Porque la tomamos ligeramente.
There are times He will call you to fall on your face.
Hay veces que él te llama para que te rindas y caigas en tu rostro.
Never allow pride.
Nunca dejes que el orgullo
to be so much in your heart
que esté tan presente en tu corazón
that you cannot fall on your faces before God.
Que tú no puedes caer en tu rostro ante
that
Dios.
You cannot drop on your knees
que tú no
before
puedes
God.
Caer y arrodillarte ante Dios.
And say, God,
y decirle, Dios,
I'm in your presence.
Estoy en tu presencia.
But in this moment,
pero en este momento,
I fall on my knees.
Yo caigo en mis rodillas.
I pay homage to you.
Traigo homenaje ante ti.
Because you are holy.
Porque tú eres santo.
I give you reverence.
Te doy
I bow before you.
Me rindo ante ti.
You are awesome.
Tú eres maravilloso.
I know at times we use the word awesome lightly.
A veces usamos la palabra maravilloso.
But that word is only reserved for one person.
Pero esa palabra está reservada para solo una persona.
For God.
Está reservada para Dios.
Our worship is always to an audience of one.
Nuestra Nuestra alabanza siempre es para una audiencia de uno.
It is before you we bow.
Es ante ti que nos rendimos.
Why? Because I'm building.
¿Por qué? Porque estoy construyendo una casa.
For your presence.
Para tu presencia.
I'm part of building that house.
Y parte de construir esa
casa. It means that I must be willing to be broken.
Significa que hay momentos donde debo estar quebrantado.
Before you, Lord.
Ante ti.
I must be willing, God.
Debo estar dispuesto, Dios.
To be able to cry.
A llorar.
In your presence.
En tu presencia.
When was the last time?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez?
You cried in his presence.
Que lloraste en su presencia.
When was the last time?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez?
You were broken before him.
Que estabas quebrantado ante él.
When was the last time?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez?
You sense he's in the room.
Que tú sentías que él estaba en este lugar.
And you had no other alternative.
Y no tenías ninguna otra alternativa.
But to be broken before him.
Que estar quebrantado ante él.
As we build a house for him.
Mientras que construimos una casa para él.
We have to be willing to say, God.
Tenemos que estar dispuestos a decir, Dios.
I am nothing.
No soy nada.
Without you.
Sin ti.
I can do nothing.
No puedo hacer nada.
Apart from you.
Alejado de ti.
I give myself away.
Me doy a mí mismo a ti.
I give myself away.
Me entrego a mí mismo a ti.
I give myself to you.
Me entrego a mí mismo a ti.
Build.
Construye.
A house that is broken.
Una casa que la cual está quebrantada.
Before you, Lord.
Ante ti, Jesús.
No, he's building a house that is broken, but he's building a house of joy.
Él no solamente está construyendo una casa que antes estaba quebrantada, pero está construyendo una casa de gozo.
In the presence of the Lord,
en la presencia del Señor,
there is fullness,
hay llenura
of joy,
de gozo.
There is something about the presence of God,
hay algo de la presencia de Dios,
that burdens are lifted,
que las cargas son quitadas,
yokes are destroyed,
que los yugos son destruidos.
You may come before him,
tú puedes venir ante él,
with the weight of this world,
con el peso de este mundo,
on your shoulders,
en tus hombros.
But there's no reason you should leave his presence.
No hay motivo por la cual debes
dejar su presencia. Carrying the weights on your shoulders.
Todavía cargando ese peso.
Because you see, when you come before him,
pero cuando tú vienes ante él,
there's something about lifting your hands.
Hay algo en el levantar tus manos.
There's something about saying, thank you, Jesus.
Hay algo en el decir gracias, Jesús.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord.
Bendecido sea el Señor.
All my soul.
Bendice, Señor,
and all that's within me.
Y todo lo que está dentro.
Bless his holy name.
Bendice su nombre entero.
When we come into his presence.
Cuando entramos a su presencia.
Come with rejoicing.
Ven regocijado.
Come with singing.
Ven cantando.
Come with dancing.
Ven danzando.
Wow. You see, in God's presence there can be an array of emotions.
Porque en la presencia de Dios puede haber una variedad de emociones.
There's brokenness.
Hay quebrantamiento.
There's rejoicing.
Hay gozo.
There's intercession.
Hay intercesión.
And next, when we come into his presence,
y lo siguiente cuando venimos a su presencia,
is the place where the impossible,
es el lugar donde lo imposible,
vanishes,
se desaparece,
it melts away,
se derrite.
Either we believe the word or we don't.
O creemos la palabra o no.
For the word of the Lord says, with God,
porque la palabra de Dios dice que con Dios,
all things,
todas las cosas,
not some, but all things.
No ciertas cosas,
somebody
todas
say
las
all.
Cosas, todos, alguien diga
with
todas.
God, all things are possible.
Con Dios, todas las cosas son posibles.
All things.
Todas las cosas.
So I'm building a house.
Así que estoy construyendo una casa.
That says,
que dice,
as a covenant son,
como hijo del pacto,
all things,
todas las cosas,
are possible,
son posibles,
to the one,
al que,
who lives in me,
vive en mí.
All things,
todas las cosas.
Finally,
y por fin,
we are to build a house,
tenemos que construir una casa,
as a place of worship,
como un lugar de adoración.
place of worship.
Un lugar de adoración.
Psalms 92 verse 3 said, "But you are holy."
Salmos 22 versículo 3 dice, "Pero tú eres santo."
Enthroned in the praises of Israel.
Entronado en las alabanzas de Israel.
Psalms 95 verse 2, "Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving."
Salmos 95 dice, "Vengamos a la presencia de Dios dando gracias."
Let us shout joyfully to him with psalms.
Que gritemos gozosamente a él con salmos.
And Psalms 100 verse 2 says, "Serve the Lord with gladness."
Y Salmos 100 versículos dice, "Sirve al Señor con dicha."
Come before his presence.
Ven ante su presencia.
With singing.
Cantando.
My friends today.
Mis amigos hoy.
As he works on you to become a living stone.
Mientras que él trabaja en ustedes para que puedan ser piedras vivas.
Built up for his presence.
Construidas para su presencia.
As he has picked you from the deposit, the quarry of the rocks.
Así como él te ha construido y te ha escogido de ese depósito de piedras.
In this moment, stand to your feet. In this
momento, levántate.
He is removing.
Él está quitando.
The stuff that need to be removed.
Las cosas que se tienen que quitar.
You see, he will not come and live in a heart that still has mess.
Porque él no puede venir y vivir en un corazón donde todavía hay desorden.
He is removing stuff.
Él está quitando cosas.
He is removing stuff from me.
Él está quitando cosas de mí aún.
I'm not yet arrived.
No, todavía no he llegado a ese lugar.
He's still removing stuff from us.
Él todavía está quitando cosas de nosotros.
But even as we get closer to him.
Pero así como cuando nos acercamos a él.
Even as we get closer to him, we begin to see clearly.
Nos acercamos a él y comenzamos a ver claramente.
Things in our lives that need to remove.
Cosas de nuestras vidas que tienen que ser quitadas.
So we say to him, "Here I am."
Así que le decimos a él, "Aquí estoy."
I give myself to you today.
Me entrego a ti hoy, Señor.
All over this place, lift your hands in his presence.
En este lugar, levanta tus manos en su presencia.
Yes. It's you and God in this moment.
Eres tú y Dios en este momento.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Thank you, Lord.
Gracias, Padre.
For some of you, he's saying, "You have not been broken before me."
Algunos de ustedes no han estado quebrantados ante mí, dice el Señor.
I've been talking at your hearts for such a long time for you to be broken before me.
He estado jalándoles el corazón por tanto tiempo para que puedan estar quebrantados ante mí.
For some of you, I've been trying to stretch your faith so you can see the impossible situation in your life melt away.
Para muchos de ustedes he tratado de, Dios dice que he tratado de estirar su fe para que puedan ver más allá del problema que está enfrente de ustedes.
Wherever you are in this moment.
Donde sea que tú estés en este momento.
Oh, it's you and God.
Eres tú y Dios.
I wish I could take the place for you, but I can't.
Me encantaría estar en tu lugar, pero no puedo.
You need to build this temple.
Tú tienes que construir ese templo.
I gotta build a temple.
Yo tengo que construir mi propio templo.
But it's you and God in this moment.
Pero eres tú y Dios en este momento.
It's you and God right now.
Eres tú y Dios en este momento.
Don't leave the same way.
No salgas de este lugar de la misma manera.
Don't leave the same way.
No salgas de este lugar de la misma manera.
Wherever you are.
Donde sea que estés.
On your journey.
En tu jornada.
Wherever you are in your building process.
Donde sea que estés en tu proceso de construir.
You have a helper.
Eres el ayudador.
It is not by might.
No es por poder.
It is not by power.
No es por poder.
But it's by his spirit, he says.
Pero es por mi espíritu, dice el Señor.
So Spirit of the Living God.
Así que Espíritu del Dios viviente.
We come.
Venimos.
We come.
Venimos.
Broken before you.
Quebrantados ante ti.
We come.
Venimos.
With a heart that says we are not satisfied.
Con un corazón que te dice que no estamos satisfechos.
With where we are.
En donde estamos.
In building.
En construir.
Building a temple that you can live in.
En construir un templo en el cual tú puedas vivir.
So today,
así que hoy,
we cleanse ourselves.
Nos limpiamos a nosotros mismos.
From all filthiness of the flesh and the spirit.
De toda suciedad de la carne o del espíritu.
And today we are perfecting holiness in the fear of God.
Y pedimos por perfección santa en el lugar de Dios.
We give ourselves to you, Lord.
Nos entregamos a ti, Jesús.
Build us.
Constrúyenos.
Build us, God.
Constrúyenos.
The rough edges in our life, remove it, God.
Esas esquinas que están ásperas.
Shape us today.
Quítalas.
Shape us.
Danos forma.
Into what you want us to be.
En lo que tú quieres que nosotros seamos.
That we can be a temple.
Que podamos ser un templo.
Ready for your use.
Listos para ser usados por ti.
I just sense the Lord want me to come in agreement with somebody this morning.
Siento que el Señor quiere que yo esté en acorde con alguien acá en este lugar.
I'm not sure where you are on your journey in building.
No sé dónde estás en tu jornada construyendo.
Building your lives for His presence.
Construyendo tus vidas para la presencia de Dios.
Whatever that journey may be.
Pero cualquier tipo de jornada en la que estés.
And you want me to agree with you in prayer? Just come and just. I'll just quickly touch your hands and we just come in agreement.
Si tú quieres que yo ore por ti, que estemos en de acuerdo en oración, ven y yo oraré por ti.
Yes, Lord. Build according to your purpose, Lord. Wherever he's in his journey, build today, God. Build today, God. Just build today, God. Wherever they are on the journey, just build today, God. Build on the journey, Lord. Build. Lord is removing the impossible situation. He said he's building today. He is rebuilding today.
Construyendo.
The Lord is building.
Él está construyendo.
He's removing every impossible situation.
Él está quitando toda situación imposible.
He's building your lives.
Él está construyendo tus vidas.
He is building your lives. The Lord is building.
Está construyendo sus vidas.
So we give ourselves to him today.
Así que nos entregamos a él hoy.
He's building today. He's building.
Él está construyendo hoy.
Lord is building you. He's building
está construyendo.
You. He's building
él te está construyendo.
He's building every area of your life.
Él está construyendo cada área de tu vida.
Situations have been removed and
las situaciones imposibles se han quitado y te está construyendo.
A great house for his glory,
en una casa grandiosa para su gloria,
he's
dice
building
él.
You. He's building
él te está construyendo.
He's building you. The
Él te está construyendo. El Señor dice que te está
he's
construyendo.
Building you. He's building
te está construyendo.
He's building you.
Te está construyendo.
He's building you.
He's
building you, he's building you, he's building you. May the Lord build you up today.
Que el amor te pueda construir hoy.
He build you, may the Lord build you today.
Que el Señor te pueda construir hoy. Que el Señor te pueda construir hoy.
Build your life.
Te pueda construir tu vida.
That gives him the glory in every area. Shine, he says. Oh, he's building you today. He's building you today. He's building you. He's building you. As you come, activate your faith and watch
mientras
God.
Mientras que tú vienes, activa tu fe.
Activate your faith.
He's activa tu fe. Él está construyendo. Él está construyendo.
He's building you today.
Él está construyendo.
The Lord is building you.
El Señor te está construyendo.
He's building you today.
Te está construyendo hoy.
Oh, hallelujah. I'm just igniting a fire.
Yo simplemente estoy encendiendo
un fuego. Your hands, but as you go back,
mientras
press in your spirit, hallelujah.
Yo toco tu mano y mientras que devuelves a tu silla, continúa presionando en el Espíritu. Está construyendo nuestras vidas para su gloria. Para su gloria. Está construyendo una vida para su gloria.
For his glory today, hallelujah. He build you for his glory.
So Father,
build this life. Build this life today. Build this life today for your glory, God. Every situation, step in, God, and bring them through today by your power, by your spirit, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you for this young man. Build for your glory, Father. Build his life. Build this life. May he be a giant for you, Lord, today. Build this young man as a great warrior in the realm of the spirit. Build his life for your glory today, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you, Father and God, that you're building lives even now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that you're building these lives in Jesus' name, that their lives will bring honor and glory to you in every area, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the life that you're building in this your son. Build this life, my God. Build a great life for your glory today. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for what you're doing even now. Thank you for this life that you're building, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you for this life that you're building, Lord. Build these lives together. Build them as a family. In the name of Jesus, I pray for greatness to be ahead of them as they look to you, Lord. We thank you right now. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We just bless you, Lord. We bless you for this life that you're building in this young man today. In Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you for their lives. Thank you, God, that you're building them, oh God, in the kingdom of God, in this season, oh God. Build them up, oh God. There'll be no shortcuts, but build them up, oh God, on the firm foundation of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father. Thank you that you're building these lives today in the name of Jesus. Build for your glory today in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you. You are the great builder of the house. You are the master builder in Jesus' name. So build this life for your glory in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father, that God, you're removing every rough edges. And God, you're smoothing out even now in the name of Jesus. A life that brings honor and glory to you, Lord. Lord, I thank you, Father and God, that, Lord, you're faithful in all of your ways. I bless you, Lord. I bless you for your faithfulness. You're building this life, oh God, to give you the glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I thank you, Lord God. I thank you for your faithfulness. I thank you, Lord God, for who you are. You are faithful in all of your ways. So build this life, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, bless your name, Lord. We thank you, Father. Oh God, she gave herself to you, Lord God. Surrender, oh God, to you everything. So build this life that brings honor and glory to your name, Lord. I thank you, Lord God. I thank you, Father and God. God, you're building a life that is broken before you. A life that says, Lord, I surrender all. A life that says, God, you have the better of me, the best of me in the name of Jesus. So we thank you, Lord God, you're building these lives in the name of Jesus. So build them up for your glory in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord God. I thank you, Father, for your faithfulness. Thank you for this young man. Build his life for you, oh God. May his life be an honor and a glory to Almighty God. Hallelujah. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for your faithfulness. God, with you, all things things are possible. So Father, we pray even now, every disappointment of the past, every hurt of the past is lifted, oh God, as you build into a new experience of you today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God is changing the situation in your life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for your faithfulness. I thank you, Lord, that you're building their lives. God, we thank you, God, that you're building Andrews and Claudia today, God. Their lives will be a blessing in the name of Jesus. Build them for your glory today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for your faithfulness. You're building, oh God. Build this young man. We call him forth as a mighty warrior. I pray, Father and God, that every hedge in his life will be built up. He will be protected on all sides in the name of Jesus. Your hand is upon him for greatness. So I pray, Father and God, you build him even in this stage of his life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Great man. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for your son. Build him up, oh God, for your glory today. Do a work in him, Lord, like never before. So, oh God, I pray you will build up, oh God, a life that brings honor and worship to your name, God. Build up, oh God, him as a worshiper today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for what you're doing in your daughter's life, Lord God. God, even in the season, oh God, the season of brokenness, season of worship, season of intercession. Build up, oh God, in a place like never before in Jesus' name. Take into a place she has never been in you. Yes, a place she has never been in you. The Lord is taking you through a door that you have never been for him, he says, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for this young man. Build him up, oh God, in the faith today. I declare he's strong, oh God, in the power of the Lord today, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for your faithfulness. Thank you that you are building your daughter up, my God. I pray, Father and God, with confidence, may she look to you today and know, God, you are her confident. You are her strength today in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord God, for your faithfulness. You get together. Thank you, Father and God, for your faithfulness, oh God, today. Build them up today, God, in the name of Jesus. Fortify them, oh God, on all sides. We bless your name, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. Build them up, oh God, in every area of life right now. We declare it so in the name of Jesus. We declare it so in the name of Jesus. I thank you for the promises of God. Yea and amen. That whatever God says, woman of God, it shall come to pass. The promises of God for your life has not fallen to the ground, but it stands firm today. So be built up in your faith. The Lord says, built up in your faith. Build your faith up and watch God move. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for this family today. In the name of Jesus, build them up, oh God. Build this young man up, oh God, into a great vessel for you. One that you can live in, my God. One you reside in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for the confidence that you have given her today. Woman of God, the Lord said, your confidence is in him. Not by your might, not by your own human efforts, but by his spirit. So, Father, today, she build up herself in the faith, even right now, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for your faithfulness. That, Father, you're building your daughter up, oh God, into greater things in you right now, in Jesus' name. So I pray as she progress forward, in the name of Jesus, she will win every battle in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for the promises of God. Yea and amen. I pray, oh God, she'll grow up to be a mighty woman of God in the earth, oh God, doing great exploits in the earth for you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for your servant today. Father, build him up right now. Fortify him. I pray, Father and God, that you'll strengthen these hands. You'll pour into him. Grace him today, God, with your strength. We thank you for your promises. Thank you for your faithfulness. Father, take him to places that he has not been in a long time. Father, take him to places, oh God, for a fresh encounter with you, God. A fresh touch, oh God, in the name of Jesus. A fresh outpouring, oh God, in the name of Jesus. A fresh move of your spirit, oh God, rest upon him today in the name of Jesus. I thank you for your faithfulness, Lord God. Hallelujah. Let's go. Give myself.
myself away. Oh, I give myself away so you can use me.
The Lord is saying to you, you are called for kingdom advancement. His grace is upon you to do great exploit in the earth. See yourself as his servant. Build up every hedges in your life. Protect yourself. Guard your heart. Because the enemy will try to come and bring you sideways. But the Lord is saying that his hand is upon you to direct your path. He's saying his hand is upon you to cause you to affect lives in the earth. As you surrender your life and every area of your life to him, the Lord is saying, I will raise you up with a clear voice in the earth for this season. A clear voice to bring forth his purpose. So today I lay hands upon you by the power of the Holy Spirit, that God will release his grace upon you, that you will bring forth destiny and purpose upon you, that Father God, there'll be a great anointing upon his life to break stronghold,